Hi everyone, this is Cheryl and welcome to my sewing room. I'm going to demonstrate an easy method for drawing your own apple pattern to use for machine applique projects. I will also demonstrate how to put the fusible web on and how to permanently fuse it onto whatever project you are making. I'll also give you suggested applique stitches to decorate the edges. And at the end of this video are projects you can stitch this apple pattern on. So let's get started. For this project, you'll need Pellon Easy Steam 2 two-sided pressure-sensitive fusible web, or you can use any other pressure-sensitive fusible web that you like. For this project, you'll also need some fabric for your apple. You can make a green apple or a red apple, and then you can use a green for the leaf and a brown for the stem, and you only need small pieces of fabric. This is about, a 5.5-inch piece of fabric, and then you'll need for the background about an 8-inch square. You'll also need either tearaway stabilizer, or I often use thin paper. So you can get any thin paper you want to use. I go to Home Depot and buy rolls of it in the paint department, and your machine stabilizer here you can buy at fabric stores. As far as your apple applique goes, you can draw it any shape you want and any size. But if you're not sure how to get it started, here's a suggestion, because I can't draw very well myself, so I always need to kind of draw a little map first before I can even get started. Draw an area on paper that is folded. Here's your folded edge. Go out 3.5 inches this way and 6.5 inches long. So this is the area that you have here. Now from the top edge, go down and put a little mark at 3/4 of an inch. This is not quite at center, it's just a little ways off from center, and it's down about 1/4 of an inch from the top. Then go over here and mark 1 1/3 of an inch from the top here. Go down from this top edge to 3.5 inches and put a mark. From the bottom edge down here, go over and put a mark at 3/4 of an inch. And then put another one up here, 1/4 of an inch from the bottom line. Then you're just gonna lightly go straight in a little bit and gently curve up, curve down, and I even went outside of the line down here, but that's okay, these are just guides. Come back down, kind of do another little curved area and go back in. Then cut on your drawn lines. Now if you don't like how your lines look, you can still erase and redraw them. So go ahead and cut that out, and when you're done, here is your little apple shape. Here is the stem, and I made mine about 1/2 inch wide and 3/4 of an inch long. Now remember, you can still draw these any size you want. My leaf is about 1 1/4 inches long, and at its widest point, it's about 1/2 inch. This is the Pellon fusible web that I'm using. And on the back, it's plain paper. On the front are these blue grid lines. This is the side you're going to trace or draw your stem, leaves, and your apples on this. I just took my little template here, laid it down, and then I used a small piece of tiny little piece of tape, and I put one here and here just to hold it in place while I was tracing around it. If you think you're going to make a lot of apples for whatever reason, I would trace this onto thin cardstock, because it's much easier to trace around cardboard than it is paper. So once you got this in place, then draw around it. When you cut it out of your sheet, leave at least a quarter of an inch around. Now it's time to put it onto your fabric. So in order to do that, you need to remove this paper off the back. If you're having a hard time getting it to come off, I just take a straight pin and just tear through that paper a little bit, then bend until a piece pops up. And remember, be careful you're not lifting the glue off of the other sheet, so it should feel sticky when you touch it. So pull this off. Now here's my fabric. Turn it over to where you see the back side and place your fusible web on the back side and finger press it down really well. Then go ahead and now cut on your drawn lines. Now it's time to remove the grid line paper off. And you do it the same way. Just take a straight pin, score the paper, make sure you tear it a little bit, bend it, try to get a little piece to pop up, and once it does, then just pull this piece off. Now, as you're lifting it off, make sure you don't lift the glue off of the fabric. That's real important because that can happen. There you go. So now, you want to make sure whatever fabric you're using on the background that you have front side facing up. And even many white fabrics have a front and back. And this one does, so it's got a print on it. So I'm going to first just set it down. Okay, I'm not going to press anything down. Once I think I have it centered, you would press it down, but I'm just going to tap it right now because I have some other pieces to add in there. For instance, this little stem. So again, score the paper, bend it, and again, be careful not to lift the glue off. And let me see if I can get this off. This is so tiny. There we go. Now what you want to do is lift up the apple a little bit and just push this underneath slightly in there like that, okay? And if you need to move it over, which I think I need to do, you can still lift it. So don't tap anything down. You're just placing things right now. Now here is the leaf. So again, tear this off and remove the paper and almost got it. Now you can put your leaf on here any way you want. I'm just putting mine on kind of like this. It's whatever you want to do. Okay, remember it's your apple block. So now once you like it, then finger press it down on all of your pieces. If you've never done the fusing process before, make sure you read the instructions on the back of your package. It's a very easy process to follow. What you will need is a damp cloth and a hot iron with steam. Now you can dampen your cloth before you lay it on top, but what I like to do is I like to lay it on a dry cloth on top, then take a spray bottle of water and dampen it real good, okay, real good. Then take a hot iron with steam, set it down on top, and hold it in place for 12 to 15 seconds. Now you would also give it a burst of steam when you first set it down. Then lift and set it down again, give it another burst of steam, hold it in place for 12 to 15 seconds. So you would do that until you have all surface covered. Then what I like to do afterwards is just let it cool down for several minutes before I do the applique stitching. Before you do any kind of applique stitching on your apple, you need to make sure you have some type of stabilizer behind your fabric. I'm using thin paper. You can also use something called tearaway stabilizer, which you can buy at fabric stores, and you can get them at Joann's, you can go on Amazon. It's available in many places. It's used a lot. So if you want paper, you can use some packing paper, which you can get at Walmart, or go in the paint department and look for rolls of paper. This is one. Now, I got mine at Home Depot because they have a big selection of different widths. You can get it in 6-inch width, 12-inch width, and on up. So I usually buy the 6 and then the 12 because I use this stuff a lot. So you would place it behind your Apple applique block. Then here are some suggested stitch patterns. This is a satin stitch here. This is a small, a medium, and a large. I rarely use the large. I mostly use the small and I use the medium a lot. Here is another applique stitch. It kind of represents a hand applique stitch, but this is done on the sewing machine. So I'm going to use the small on the leaf and the stem and the medium on the apple itself. When you're stitching, I recommend that you use an open toe presser foot. And the reason why I suggest that, because when the needle comes down right there in the center, you can see exactly where you are stitching. So that's why I recommend them. And you would keep that center of the presser foot right on the edge of the apple. Now you can get these at sewing machine supply stores and on Amazon.com. Here is your stitching order. You always want to stitch the piece that is on the very bottom. For instance, the apple and the leaf is on top of the stem. So you would do the stem first. So just stitch around and stop at the leaf. The next one you would do is the apple itself, because the leaf is on top of it. So you would start here, stitch all the way around, and stop right there up against the leaf. Then you would do the leaf last because it is on top. As far as thread goes, I'm going to use red for the apple, green for the leaf, and brown for the stem. After you're done with all of your applique stitching, just turn it over and tear the paper off on the back side. It'll come off really easy. For more machine applique projects, play this video to the very end where you will see a green screen, and then click on the links. If you like this video, please click on thumbs up and also click on share to share this video with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then click on that red button down there in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. Click on that little bell and then enter your email address so that you'll receive future email notifications about my latest video. If you don't seem to be receiving those notifications, go to your cell phone, click on settings, and set notifications in the on position. I'm Cheryl. This is Manny. Thanks again for coming by. See you next time. Happy sewing!